it's Coach Stacy. Hey, just real quick, I wanted to show you how to take before and after photos. I know people get really nervous about pictures. Guys, I will never share your photo unless you give me permission to, okay? You have my promise on that. If for some reason you rock out this challenge and I'm like, please let me share what you did and your results, it would be an honor for you to allow me to do that. But I will never pressure you into things like that, okay? So always know, number one, that I respect your privacy, especially when it comes to our body. There's so many emotional things that occur with nutrition, fitness, and mindset that are surrounding going for a goal, helping our bodies be better, and just coming into our best body and self. So you have my promise on that. However, let's tell you how to take before pictures, and I call them progress pictures. We want to, on a 14-day challenge or any challenge, we want to do it. Okay, beginning picture before you actually start is the most important, midway, and the ending for every bit of it. So if you miss a week in between and you have longer than a 14-day challenge, it's okay. I don't prefer it because it's how we course correct, is knowing that's this information. Body pictures and inch measurements, knowing what your muscle and fat's doing, those are the critical measurable data and actions and results that actually help me and your coach, me and your coach, your coach, you, me, all of us make those changes so we get you progress. But this is why pictures are important, and I'm gonna show you how to make them good, okay? I'm going to add some lighting here for me. I probably should have done it at a better angle, I apologize. But you need good lighting. Ooh, that got cinematic on us, didn't it? So what I want you to do, number one rule of before pictures, progress pics here on out. You need the same wall behind you, so find a good spot. Good lighting, better than what I've got right now. And I want you wearing the same clothes if possible. Do not wear all black. Man, come on, Coach Stacy, lead by example. I got black pants on, right? But it's because I've got a whitish wall behind me and I needed it to pop. But all black, you would think it is slimming, but it doesn't let you see the changes as well. Two, create space. Don't just stand like this, okay? Because I can't see anything and neither can you. And these pictures are supposed to help us celebrate your wins. So when you're standing, get that, stand up tall, roll that chest in, or the core in a little bit. Stand up super tall like you're looking over a crowd and get some space between those arms, okay? And between those legs. Because I promise you, as your body transforms, you'll be able to see changes here, 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 and through here. And when you take your picture, don't cut it off right here, because so much transformation occurs through the biggest muscles of the body. And we want to be able to see that. So create that shoulder width apart stance. Stand up tall. Get those shoulders up but back. You don't need to shrug. And just relax. Okay? And smile. Smile. Don't look miserable in those pics. Okay, so stand here. We want a forward-facing picture where you're looking straight at the camera, same angle, same lighting, same background every time. Do you notice how I'm standing right here where I can see the line of that wall? If you've got a doorway or lines of the wall, try to use that, because for some reason those straight lines will actually visually help you see the changes in your body as well. Okay, just a tip. If you don't have that, just use the best space that you got. Then you will do a side pick. So you will stand to the side, and notice I don't have my shirt tucked in or anything, and so it's kind of blousy. Go ahead, and if you have to, just tighten it on the other side. We want you to be able to see your silhouette, because this is what's gonna help you make changes, okay? Still standing up tall, and just relax right here. If you can create space, or if you wanna have your hands straight down, go ahead. We just wanna be able to see the curve here and the curves here, okay? That's the idea. So like maybe like right here, so you can still see it. Or, I mean, you're welcome to be right here and put your hands here if that would help you, okay? We just wanna see that body and the changes that are occurring. One more picture. We need a behind picture. So where you face the wall directly so that you can, and do the same thing, stand up tall, keep those arms away from the sides, legs shoulder width apart, and just super stand up so we can see the silhouette. If you have long hair, I would go ahead and tuck it so that you can actually see the changes in the back that are occurring too. Good job. It's as easy as that. It sounds simple, but if you've never done it before, these tips I hopefully will help you see and have that progress just so pop, okay? I promise you, pictures will help you celebrate, especially weeks from now when you've done all the hard, good work, the few bits of actionable steps that actually bring results, and you can see that before pic and that progress pic, you will celebrate. And your mind won't play tricks on you either, because you'll be able to see the difference, because your body will respond. I love it. Guys, go have a good day. Stay strong, stay well, and get your power back. Woo! So, a few tips, modern day and age. How do you take your own self pictures? Guys, if you don't have an area where you can prop your phone up and just take a selfie, here's some options, okay? Have somebody else help you. If you don't have anybody to help you, tell your coach, me. I will do it for you. Come into the studio and I'll take your before and after photos if you want. Or three, guess what? Our phones are so capable these days. If you pull up your pictures, even like if you have like an Apple, if you're on an Android device, you can probably Google how to do this. But by the way, there is really good step-to-step tutorials on how to use different devices for things at Chasms, that you can pull up any device and it shows you how to, like what it looks like, steps to get to certain control panels and settings and blah, blah, blah. But very basic, when you're taking a picture, there's like this little arrow, like a V at the top. If you click that, it opens up some other tools, at least on my Apple product, where you can, you'll see a little mini timer looking like clock, and you click that and you can literally set it to where at 3 seconds or 10 seconds to where it'll count down for you and it'll take the picture for you. If you can't figure that out, you could also create a video like I did right now with my iPhone and just play the video and then do your pictures this way. Turning to the side for a few seconds, turning to the back, get your three image shots from your before and progress pics, and then you can do a snapshot picture of the frame that you want of the video. And it's easy to do. You usually just click the power button and the volume button, and it'll take a screenshot for you of the picture. I breathed wrong while I was talking. I apologize. So hopefully that helps you have a quick tip on how to make your own selfies for your before and after photos pop for you and easy, whether you have help taking them or not. Get your power back.